All right, BattleTech enthusiasts, we are continuing our mech analysis here, talking about sharing some experiences with the various mechs that not only I enjoy playing, but also mechs that I struggle to play, either because I have a preconceived notion of how this machine should be played, or what's a little bit more challenging is when you have mechs of similar roles, but a difference in weight class. And this is where the Panther really shines, in that you might play a heavier medium mech with certain damage output, and then a similar medium or light mech with the same damage output, but you're playing it like the heavy mech on there. The example of this, the PPC. Now, admittedly, there's a lot of great ways to play BattleTech, and one of my core strategies is big guns never tire. I encourage you to have tactics. I encourage you to use deception and guile. But in the face of multiple autocannon 20s bearing down on you, you can have your refused flank, you can have your fancy tactics. There is no arguing with big guns. So I like to naturally populate. I should play House Steiner, right? Where every mech's an assault mech. Your scout lance is four atlases. But I like to take big guns and aggressively use them. So I'm naturally attracted to this. And admittedly, with the role of many light mechs, either a scouting role or a spotting role or kind of a cash and grab, run, pick up an objective, run away, or skirmish mode, I do really like the Thorn, and we're going to take a look at the Thorn in the next podcast. But now we have the Panther. It's got a PPC, so I'm initially attracted to it. That's the first thing that I notice that you notice. And the thing about a PPC is you've got good range, you've got heat to manage, but in the case of a light mech not really having any other weapons on it, it's not as big a problem as, say, playing something like an Awesome where you're repeatedly trying to cook out three of these a turn. But the 10 damage is consistent. And what I like with BattleTech weaponry, I try to look for consistent damage versus non-consistent. And what that means is if I can dish out, look, I have to hit with anything. Even if you cook off an LRM 20 pack before you roll the spread, you have to be able to see where you're going to hit and what it's going to do and how much damage on there. But it's a big spread on the clusters. Large lasers, 8 points of damage. We're talking inner sphere here. Stuff like PPCs, stuff like autocannon 20s, that is consistent, solid damage. And I like to generally start at 10 or higher. So here we have a light mech that has a PPC. What that means in theory is now if I'm going to gang up on light mechs, if I'm going to take my light mech and go against your light mech, that's going to be an interesting exchange. Can you afford to consistently take, okay, yeah, it also has the missiles to fire too, but can you afford to consistently take 10 points a turn on there? Likewise, there's the temptation to go up against heavier machines, supported, of course, not unsupported. I'm not going to take my Panther and throw it up against your Warhammer, but if I go up against, if I have a similar classed machine, maybe like a Marauder, and I'm using the Panther as a bodyguard, hanging back a little bit, I engage my Marauder with your Warhammer, and now I outflank and try to get side or rear shots with the Panther on your Warhammer, that's a PPC. We're not talking about a locust flanking you and hitting you with that medium laser and some machine guns or the SRM variant. PPC is big. So we have a mech that you want to play more aggressively and take advantage of that PPC. But the first thing that you notice is the speed is really bad. The speed is really, really bad. So with that, what I find is we're not using it to hunt light mechs, because the light mechs are just going to run away. Or they're going to keep their distance. Like, let's say you can corner a light mech based on mission parameters. Maybe they have to be somewhere specific on the board. Or the physical limitations of your hex map. You get someone up against the corner. They can't retreat. You're going in there. But as soon as I start putting on range and I start stacking on the movement modifiers of a light mech, it becomes very, very hard to actually hit you. And you only have that one PPC. You don't have the redundancy. So on paper, it looks like, hey, I'm going to hunt things out with the Panther. I'm going to be a Panther and hunt down those light mechs. Not really going to happen. So now if we throw them as a bodyguard with medium or heavy mechs, again, this example of it's with my Marauder and I'm going against your Warhammer, there's the challenge here I find is that I need to have my tactics down solid, meaning my timing of when I'm going to commit, when I'm not going to commit. And likewise, I have to be aware of what else is around, because if my opponent in that medium, heavy, or assault mech decides to target my Panther, there's really not much I can do about it. It doesn't have the consistent speed to withdraw. And the liability here is, this is why we could argue having infantry as a placeholder is massive. Once initiative is huge in the game, and as soon as you, let's say we're playing four mechs versus four mechs, it's about equal battle value. As soon as I lose one mech, that is huge. That and lose could be destroyed, or I'm immobilized, I got my legs blown off. As soon as I lose that initiative sink to react, now it starts to be piled on. As soon as you lose two initiatives, where you know you have two more pieces than me, now as we close, you're gonna get rear and side shots. So that's the challenge I find with this mech. The big gun is nice. I love it. Big guns never tire. But the speed really makes the machine challenging. Really challenging to play. That said, I do find it good as a vehicle hunting type mech, because vehicles generally, I mean, I'm not going to chase down hovercraft, but if you're doing combined arms, I gave up chasing down hovercraft. You know, maybe I'll go after it with my hovers, but we're just going to like let you come to me. But with a combined arms list, where we're playing tanks and mechs and infantry support, it does make a good vehicle hunter. It has the speed to be comparable with it. It's got the PPC, it's got the armor, it's got, don't have to worry about motive hits, things like that. But I could equally argue that there are better vehicles that hunt vehicles and could engage mechs. So with that, and we all have our favorite mechs, and I do enjoy playing the PPC. I do enjoy the mech. It's a fun mech, but it's kind of a mixed bag tactically with how it works.